this needs to be over here.
No, because if you try to fit this through.
Here in Beaufort County School District, we have 5 schools that offer Project Lead the Way, a gateway to technology. And they are Bluffton High School, Bluffton Middle School, H.E. McCracken Middle School, Ladies Island Middle School, May River High School, River Ridge Academy, and Well Branch Middle School.
Project Lead the Way, a gateway to technology, is a national STEM curriculum. It's meant to introduce children to problem-solving techniques, focusing on engineering and computer science, and some biomedical science.
Here at Bluffton Middle School, the Project Lead the Way Gateway to Technology program, we focus on design and modeling, which is a foundational course for all of the rest of the courses in the Project Lead the Way program. We do offer 2 specialty courses here. One of them is automation and robotics, and the other one is medical detectives. The automation and robotics program has students actually building robots and programming them to take to competitions.
The games change every year, so they have different objectives they need to do year after year. So it requires them to design and build robots literally from scratch to solve and compete in those matches.
The kids do it all. They build it, they program it, and it really promotes teamwork because there's nobody can sit there and not talk, because you got to discuss things with your partner. And it makes them think outside the box, you know, when you're problem solving.
Well, we have to come up with an idea, and then we try to build that. And then when things don't work, we have to go back, figure out what went wrong, and rebuild it.
You get to, like, use your imagination and do whatever you want. And if you have ideas, you can share them and use them. And in the competitions, you test it and see how it works.
Students that participate in Project Lead the Way and Gateway to Technology classes are preparing themselves for the 21st century high school and the 21st century job field.
I think it teaches them a lot, and I think this is the way the future is going to go, that learning all the things that they learn, the programming, building the robot, and problem solving are all things that they can use in any way.
We focus on problem solving, real world problem solving. So no matter what the problem is, what we're really trying to have kids do is become self-sufficient, student-centered learners and create authentic products to solve real world problems. So it could be a robot, it could be a computer application, it could be a designing and building a green livable structure.
I felt like in engineering you can experience new things. You could, you know, it's kind of inventing the new way people think, and new objects and new inventions really expand the world and help people to a better future and the world.
It's not just sitting in class and doing worksheets. Everything's, you're actually doing something with your hands, or you're building something, or you're on your own software. And like I tell all the kids at first, like, don't like the class because it's tough. But then once they figure out what's going on, oh, this is easy. So it kind of makes the kids excel a little bit, kind of push them.
Well, I think one of the things that's missing from traditional education is being able to tie together what you learn in your science or your English or your math class. And so a STEM curriculum allows students to get outside of those classroom environments and actually learn how to apply what they're learning in those independent classes in a real world situation. And so they immediately become more employable, more flexible learners, can handle our changing technology world more effectively.
I love, like, getting to build things, like getting to put, like, my input into, like, all of the engineering and the programming, and really getting to, like, show different ways that, like, I can grow through the robot.
It's a known fact that STEM opportunities in college and in the career world are out there, and they're not being filled. So it's our responsibility, I feel like, in education to at least give foundations at the middle school level, where they can then go on to the high school level if they have interest in these fields and pursue them, go on to college, and then find careers in STEM jobs.
Problem solvers, that's our future. Bottom line, you know, you're always going to need people to solve problems, and you're always going to need people to use their hands in order to solve those problems through the computer side. Again, you have your principles and your formulas that you use, but then you have to put it to action. And that's why these classes are so much fun. You're creative, you get to design something that maybe nobody's ever thought of.
I think all the Project Lead the Way Gateway actually help promote what really goes on in the real world. Teamwork and problem solving.
So we need to teach kids how they can be flexible learners so they can learn whatever skill they need to learn for the jobs that don't exist yet.